Hello friends, in our previous session we have seen how all the accounts are classified into real, personal and nominal accounts. We also have an idea about the dual aspect concept or the double entry system of accounting, which states that every transaction has two equal effects. Without recording both the effects or dual effects in books of accounts, our record will be incomplete or imbalance and it will show a wrong status. Now let's go one step further and talk about what are these two equal effects. One of these two effects is always a debit and other effect is always a credit. So what are these terms, debit and credit? They are just formal bookkeeping and accounting terms that have opposite meanings. These are like the pillars of accounting on which the entire accounting is based. Now let's proceed further. A few days ago, I was at my friend Peter's grocery store and was checking to see how easy keeping his records. So here we have picked 5 random transactions from Peter's book and we are going to analyze each one of them. So the first transaction is, now this is a sales transaction. To analyze this, the important thing to do is to find out which are the two accounts that will be affected as per the dual aspect concept. Here, goods have been sold, so the sales account will be affected. And second would be Mr. Adams' account, as the goods are sold on credit. Now, next step is classify these accounts into real, personal and nominal. As we have discussed in our previous session, all the incomes comes under the nominal account, therefore sales is a nominal account. And the accounts which relate to the person comes under the personal account. So Adam's account is a personal account. Now the question is, which account should we debit and which should we credit? So whenever a person receives a benefit in the form of goods or cash, the account of the person is debited by the amount of the benefit received. So Mr. Adams' account is debited since he is a receiver of the goods. That is, he is a debtor. The person who is in debt, that is the debtor, is debited. So the second account affected, sales account, which is a nominal account, it's like a revenue. Now all revenues, incomes and gains increases the profit of the business and so we credit them. Like we have seen that every debit has an equal and corresponding credit effect, here we have one debit and one credit effect. So the correct entry is Mr. Adams account debit and sales account credit. So now onwards we will check every transaction by following these 3 steps. Now let's look at the second transaction. Now this is a purchase transaction and this is Peter's entry. Let's analyze it. Now the first is the accounts affected. So here one is Mr. Alfred account and the second is purchase account. Now here purchase comes under the nominal accounts and Mr. Alfred is a personal account. Now we will come to the third step, debit and credit. When a person gives the benefit of goods or cash, that is the creditor, his account is credited by the amount of the benefit given. So Mr. Alfred's account will be credited. So here person who gives the credit, that is the creditor, is credited. Now the second account is a purchase account, which is a nominal account, is an expense. Now all the expenses and losses decreases the profit of the business and hence they are debited. Here one trick is the word debtor and creditor itself is giving the answer. Debtor, debit, creditor, credit. Now let's move on to the next transaction. Here, note that only those purchase or sales transactions where it specifically mentioned that payment was in cash is considered to be a cash transaction. If cash is not mentioned, it is assumed to be a credit transaction. And so, the debit or credit effect will be given to the party's name mentioned. Let's see what Peter has done. So here, do you think Roy's account should be affected? No, because this transaction is a cash transaction. So no party will be affected. So in this case, furniture and cash are the two accounts affected. And as we know, assets will come under the real accounts. So furniture and cash both will come under the real account. Okay? Now, whenever an asset comes into the business through its purchase or receipt, asset account is debited. So here we have purchased furniture. So furniture will be debited. Conversely, whenever asset goes out of the business through its sales or payment, asset account is credited. And here we have paid cash, so it will get credited. Now let's see next transaction. Now here the two accounts which are affected are salary account and cash account. Now salary is a nominal account as it's an expense of the business. So it will have debit effect, right? And second is a cash, as it comes under the real account, it's an asset of the business. Asset going out of the business, so it will be credited. So the second part is correct. All okay so far? The last one. Now here, Peter debited commission account. Let's analyze this transaction. First step, which are the two accounts? One is commission and second is cash account. Second, classification. Commission will come under the nominal account as it's an income of the business. And cash will come under the real account as it's an asset. So here we will debit cash account as we have received the cash, and we will credit commission account as it is the income of the business. With this, we have finished checking Peter's book and rectified it. We have also understood what is debit and credit, and we have learned logical understanding of debit and credit effect. Now here are some rules of each type of account. So if we notice, in first example, we have debited the person who is receiving the benefit, and in second example, we have credited the person who is giving the benefit. So when any transaction includes persons, then the rule of personal account is debit the receiver, credit the giver. And in third example, we have debited the asset which is coming into the business, and we have credited the asset which is going out of the business. So when any transaction includes assets, then the rule of real account is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. And in fourth and fifth example, we have debited the expenses and we have credited incomes. So when any transaction is of expense, incomes, losses and gains, then the rule of nominal account is debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So hope you guys have understood this concept. So here is a small exercise for you all. So that's all for today's session. I hope you all have enjoyed this session. If you like this, give us a thumbs up. And if you have any queries, share it on comment box given below. For further session, please subscribe to our channel. We all are here to help you to understand accounting in a more logical and interesting manner. Thank you.